challenges in developing a franchise business in Indonesia. In developing the Peru franchise business plan in 2004 to 2006, I was asked a difficult question. Why, as an entrepreneur, would I choose a franchise business format to expand my company? This question is very fundamental, and it got me thinking long and hard about the consequences of choosing to franchise Peru. Why? A franchise business requires a cooperative effort between one franchisor and many franchisees. As an illustration, as of October 2021, Peru franchise recorded a total of 235 franchises. For such a partnership to work, parties must bind themselves to each other through a franchise agreement. In the event of dispute between the parties, franchise agreement becomes the main reference point. It provides written evidence of what parties have agreed upon at the beginning of the relationship. Sometimes, disputes might end up in court. However, due to the inefficiencies in the country's legal system, going to court in Indonesia is often not even considered as an option for entrepreneurs. As such, the risk of litigation from dealing with many franchisees instinctively discourages business people from adopting the franchise model. Entrepreneurs like myself certainly have the option to grow their businesses in ways other than franchising. A chain business, a business that opens many branches and has its operation managed and controlled by a centralized office, can be a realistic and profitable option. A chain business is corporate owned, meaning that the company owns and operates all of the stores. There are already many examples of successful chain business in Indonesia.